Hey everybody, Renegade410 here with another gear review for you. Today we're going to be talking a little bit about a new piece of tactical type gear that I've got, a 511 tactical vest. And I'm going to be speaking a little bit about its functionality, what I use it for, and what I think it would be really good for. It's obviously, you know, they all come with a little tag. And the tag pretty much shows you all of the different options. There's lots of different pockets and places to hold stuff and all kinds of places you put different kinds of gear. And I think it's a great piece of clothing that if you're going to use it for lots of different things, or you're going to use it for one very specific thing, it's still going to work out for you regardless of how you use it. And I can use it in both, you know, a casual sense and a tactical sense if necessary for police work or something like that. The 511 Tactical Series vests and some of their other equipment have what they call a backup belt system, which is some extra gear that you can attach to this, that I happen to also have those pouches and stuff like that, and we'll get into that. But first I want to get into the vest itself and show you a little bit of the options and things that it comes with, and we'll go from there. If you check out 511's website, they again have a very good description of it. They're telling us on the website that it's got 18 pockets, and it's got to have at least that if it doesn't have more. It's made out of 8.5-ounce cotton. It's, again, got pockets all over the place, got all kinds of stuff, and we'll get into that right now. On the one side of the vest here, you got a large pocket at the bottom. Good for, you know, just storing stuff, whatever you need to throw in there. But inside the pocket, as you can see, it's got elastic loops, which are very good for pistol magazine holders. You can keep a pistol magazine in there and close that up, and you don't even know. That's for a Sig Sauer P226, and if it's in there, no problem. You can put three magazines in there. They'll fit in any one of the slots. You know, they're elastic, so they'll stretch. You can get it in there, and they fit well. It'll hold a bunch of different types of magazines. It holds the Sig magazines. It'll hold my 1911 magazines. It actually holds, I tried it with my partner's Glock, it holds Glock magazines. Whatever you need, it's elastic, so it stretches. And on top of that, after you put those in there, you still do have plenty of room if you wanted to stash something else in there, flashlight, knife, something like that. You fit that in there real easy. Above that pocket, on what's the right side of the vest if you were wearing it, got another pocket with a key ring. This is great for holding, you know, car keys, house keys, whatever you want to put on there. Maybe you have a flashlight on a ring or something like that, on a split ring. You could put it on the key ring and it just hangs there. Or you could stash it inside the pocket. Again, pocket fairly, you know, pretty deep. Good for holding flashlight, or if you have a knife, you want to stick a knife in there. Put the knife in there, it holds very well. Maybe if you're going to use it in a tactical sense, some shotgun shells would fit very nicely in there. Above that, you have just a regular pouch pocket that you could put, you know, any like handy wipes or something in. Just throw those in there, hand wipes, things like that. It's always good to have those. On the other side of the vest, on the outside, you have these two lower pockets, which fit AR, M16, M4 magazines. They fit them very well. We have a 30-round AR mag here. No problem. Fits right in there. Also, fit anything else that you may have that's tall and skinny. If you don't have anything to fit in there, again, anything that you can clip on works well. I clip a knife in here sometimes. You know, just clip it right to the top of the pocket. Flashlight. If you have maybe something, a skinny bottle of something, maybe prescription medicines that you need to keep with you or something, you can throw those in these pockets, and they hold them very well. They're nice and deep. You're not going to lose anything. They bellow out a little bit, as you can see, so you can fit a whole, you know, a full magazine or something in there. Behind the AR magazine pockets and behind the large pocket over here are two hand warmer pockets, so you could stick some little odds and ends in there, put your hands in there if you need to, something like that. Above the AR pockets, as we bring this a little closer, a zippered pocket, good for holding onto other little items about the same size as the pocket on the other side. good to fit knife, flashlight, something like that in. On top of that, you have a nice metal D-ring, which if you choose to keep your keys already on some sort of hook, you can just hook them right to that. Or if you have maybe a set of gloves on a carabiner or something, you can hook them on there. That's a great little option for some stuff like that. Above that, two smaller pockets, one good for a pen, as you can see. That's what I keep in the one pocket. And the other one, just another pocket, good for maybe a cell phone, page, or something of that variety. It's, it's fairly deep. And it's good for holding something of the page or cell phone size. Above that, you have a strap here that's got Velcro. You need to take, say, a radio. Put a radio and clip a radio mic to that. The radio, most radios will fit very nicely also in the AR magazine pocket. You could fit a fairly large size radio, something from Motorola or Vertex or something like that would fit very well in there. And you can run your mic up to here and clip the mic up here, which is great. This way it's up close. As you can see, NRA, just like those 511 tactical shirts that I have. I purchased this from the NRA store. I am a life member of the NRA, and I suggest that everybody join the NRA, at least be an annual member, contribute a little bit, try and save the things that we have, the laws and the regulations that we have, and try and make some of the bad ones better. But NRA stuff, so I like it. They have a lot of good stuff on their website and on the NRAstore.com, and some of it's slightly less expensive than if you were to buy it somewhere else at another store. On the back of the vest, you got a couple of big pockets here with some elastic, good for water bottles, things like that, two of those. Water bottle, soda bottle, whatever you might want to carry in there. You got a big map style pocket back here that you could take, put a map in, or some other stuff. If you're going to use this maybe as a photographer's vest, you could fit some film and whatnot in there. If you're going to use this and you have children, maybe some little toys or something for the kids. The vest does have these, it's two snaps to size it up if you want to cinch it up a little. It's got them on both sides. The back is a vented back, which is nice now that the summer's here where I live. You know, get some airflow in there so you're not sweating when you're wearing this. And it's got a little tab on the back so you can hang it if you need to hang it on a hook or something like that. The inside of the vest, again, big pouch pocket in here that if you need to stash something, you can stash a lot of stuff in there. It's a big old pocket. Again, good for a map or something like that. On the inside, it also has another pocket, just a regular inside pocket, nice and deep, good for documents, good for holding other things, throw a pair of sunglasses in there or something, sits way down at the bottom, and you don't have to worry about losing them. It also has on the inside these straps here, good for strapping them around your belt so the vest doesn't move. You can just unsnap them, put the belt through, slide that over and snap it down. Washing instructions, of course, in case you need to wash them. And on top of that, the backup belt system gear that 511 has fits on the inside of the vest. You can open this up in here, two very large pockets, one on each side, open it up, and there's a mesh. There's a hook and loop inside, and then this panel. As you can see here, there's an internal panel that is removable. You can move it around. That is, again, the hook and loop, and you can attach the backup belt system gear to it. And currently, I have on here a holder for an expandable baton, or a mace, or a flashlight, whatever one you want to use it for. I like the open top for the baton, so I've been having the baton in there. I've been using this going back and forth to work, just throwing this over top of my Under Armour and my gun and going around with it, keeping an expandable baton in there. It also has the backup belt system. If you get the complete package, has a baton, mace, double magazine holder, holster for a gun, and a pouch for a set of handcuffs. So you get five options to add more versatility to this particular vest. Again, I think it's a great piece of equipment. If you're going to be going out, maybe on vacation somewhere, and you want to be able to carry your stuff around and not leave it at the hotel or whatever, you got plenty of options in the 511 tactical vest. It's a great thing. I'm actually really glad I purchased it. I've been carrying it around. Like I said, I've been wearing it every day, and I think it's a great piece of equipment, and I'm going to keep using it. Wouldn't give it up. It's a great little thing. All right, guys, comments, questions, concerns, by all means, let me know, and stay safe out there.